Hello, thanks for joining me. The snows are gone, the frost is still in the ground, so we got about 3, 4, 5 inches of spongy, thawed, wet ground soils on top of the frost layer underneath that. But no flooding, the snows melted off and the waters were able to flow away without any major flooding this year. And it's starting, just starting to green up. The marsh grasses, the sedges are now exposed and some new shoots are coming up. The moss and the lichens are showing their green as well. There's an occasional dandelion that's actually popping up. But for the most part, the first sign of spring here in the low, wet, marshy areas is the skunk cabbage. Okay, that was the Eastern Skunk Cabbage, and that is the first flower of spring in the low marshy areas here. That flower is able to generate heat. It can generate a temperature of about 70 degrees and maintain that for a couple weeks, and it's able to melt its way through the snow and the frost in the soil. It gets its name because it kind of smells like rotting meat, skunky, and it's able to attract early pollinators. It's a nice day. St. Patrick's Day has come and gone, and I saw there were a lot of videos out on that. And I am smoking not because of that, just because I like it. Uhle's Irish Aromatic. Irish Aromatic is a, who knows what it is. The Uhle site says it's black Cavendish and flavored brown Cavendish. The tobacco review website says there's a few more tobaccos in there than just Cavendish. They say there's a little bit of Latakia, some Burleys, and some Virginia. And I tend to think there's more than just Cavendish in this blend, or maybe I want to think there's more than just Cavendish in this blend, but it certainly looks like there's some Virginia flakes or Virginia pieces of tobacco in it. But it's a sip it slowly, and it's a wonderful aromatic, very light aromatic, with the Irish mist or Irish cream, I guess it would be, flavoring to it. Nimrod was failing me there. Normally it's a one flick light, but there's enough wind out here to keep it from igniting. And I'm smoking this Uhle's Irish Aromatic in a Dublin shape, obviously. This is a Kaywoodie super grain. And I'm not really sure why it's classified as a super grain. You know, it's got some beautiful bird's eye, and both here and the flanks have the straight grain going across it. It is super, but as I understand it, the super grain was a mid-grade of the Kaywoodie pipes. This is an older one, not real old because it's got the three-hole stinger in it, the drinkless system. But anyway, the wood on this is just an outstanding piece of briar. There are no fills in it. There are a couple tiny, tiny sand pits in it, very small. I thought about sanding them out, but it wasn't even worth it. I got this for $5 at an antique store. And I guess the topic of this video is in praise of old briar. I do a little bit of used pipe shopping, state pipes. You do find Dr. Grabo is the older ones with the screw-in bits. Kaywoodies, Medicos, Yellow Bowls, Bradbury, Allied. A lot of different pipes out there. And for the most part, $5 to $20, whatever they are, you really can't go wrong. The older briar has that reddish-brown look to it, and it's really easy to find the fills, that the pinkish-whitish material that so many companies used. So it's easy to pick through some pipes and find, you know, inexpensive pipes that have just terrific pieces of briar on them. Obviously, there's the expense or the time involved with cleaning them up. Some of them are quite filthy and take quite a bit of time to clean up. Others, like this one, were very clean. The cake had only built up in the top third of the bowl. The bottom of the bowl was basically bare wood. The heel never developed any cake on it. Took next to no effort to get the little bit of cake that was in there out of there. And the shank cleaned up very quickly. There was very little tar residue in there. So sometimes you luck out, you get a perfectly drilled pipe. Other times the drilling is way off, or the bowls are cracked. Little stuff. They still smoke. You can still use them. And for the price, they're fine. So, in praise of old briar, good stuff. And I suppose part of that has to do with the fact that they've already been smoked in. There's no break-in period for the most part. It may take a smoke or two to put a little carbon back on the inside of the bowl. Very quickly, they're perfectly smoking pipes. So, I don't have a lot of them. I do this very infrequently. I've given a lot of them away. I've sold couple of them, but I'll give you a shot of some of the estate pipes that have cleaned up very nice. I'll show you some estate pipes that are real bargains as far as I'm concerned. I'll start here with, actually this is the pipe I had out today, so perhaps you can see it a little bit better here. This is the Kaywoodie. Bird's eye on both the front and the back, and the two flanks have the cross-cut grain. Very pretty. And, well, we've talked about the fact that it has the metal screw bit in it. This is a classic American pipe, the Weber. This is the Virgin Standard. And some nice flame grain on that side. Virgin Standard from Weber. This is a pipe I don't know much about, or the company. It is called an Allied Super.
And the grain on this is really super. Flame grain goes all the way around it. Nice little apple shape. The other side stamped is real briar. Out of New York, Bradbury Pipe Company. This is from the Town and Country line, limited edition. Stamped virgin briar on one side. Lots of bird's eye in this straight Rhodesian. This is also a screw bit with a ball type stinger on it. A large apple, stamped imported briar, lots of bird's eye on it. No idea who is the manufacturer of this pipe, but lovely large apple pipe. The F on this one is pretty easy to recognize, a Frank's Medico. Solid piece of briar, but not very much grain whatsoever. Just a no fills, nice piece of briar in a filtered pipe, 6mm paper filter. Over this little rack here. This is a unknown manufacturer. This is an imported briar. Pretty nice grain on that. This came in a Mastercraft box, but I'm quite sure it's not a Mastercraft. This is my oldest pipe. This is a yellow bowl, stamped honey-cured briar, which puts it in the mid-1930s. A nice Lovat of no name. Some Dr. Graybows. Here is a Starfire. With lovely wire rustication on it. And the Graybow is going to have the adjustomatic stem with the spoon type stinger. And another Dr. Graybow. This is a Regal, a nice piece of briar, some rustication. And this too has the adjustomatic screw stem on it. And another rusticated pipe. This is an Albertsen Vienna Meerschaum. It is Meerschaum lined. And all of these pipes were $10 or less. This is my most expensive estate pipe at the moment. It is a Savinelli 703KS from the Extra line. A lot of these old estate pipes can be got for a very, very good price. And they take a little bit of cleaning, but they're nice pieces of briar, and they'll last a long time. Thought I'd give you a little tour here. Some metal pipes, everyday smokers, some meerschaums and cases back there, corn cobs up there, some other pipes in the cabinet in the wall, some church wardens up there. Somewhere around here there are 60 pipes. Where they are at any given moment is a very good question, but there are 60 of them bouncing around here somewhere.
So, I hope you enjoyed that. The wind is kind of breezy, and it's pretty strong. It's variable direction, so hopefully the audio on the video is not terrible. So, as spring approaches, I hope all of you are getting out and taking advantage of the beautiful weather that's in store for us. At least it's a short window before the ticks and the mosquitoes start to hatch, but spring and fall are the best months. Winter is the third best, and summer, I don't care for bug season. But that's just me. I know most people are the other way, so hope you enjoy the spring leading into the summer. Hope you're doing well, and take care, and perhaps I shall see you again.